Good morning, welcome back to another video here from the off-grid garage. Looks like it will be sunny. Not hot. Freezing cold this morning, but 6 or 7 degrees only. But the sun is already nice and warm. I'm not talking about the weather today, but about the QUCC BMS again. I have doing a little experiment again. I shouldn't say this anymore, I know. The whole life is an experiment, right? I have discharged the battery to 2.5 volts last night, charged the car. I did a video on the car channel actually, so I needed to fully charge the car in one go to measure the energy and everything. And it appeared the battery was down to 2.6 volts, cell number 6. Our friend, cell number 6. Yeah. This morning I turned on the car again to discharge the battery again to see what actually was happening, and the QUCC BMS disconnected. So, and this is what I want to simulate again, because I wasn't there to actually observe what is going on. So, what I'm going to do now is I will turn off the charger and the east roof as well. 200 watts are missing. Charger enabled. Check the shunt. Low state of charge, low voltage, this is all good. And there is no charge coming in. We are discharging with 1.4 amps at the moment, 70 watts for the inverter and light in here. So, okay, here are the parameters of the QUCC BMS I have set. So interesting in this case is the undervoltage, undervoltage release and release delay. Undervoltage is set to 2.55 volts. So battery will turn off. The BMS will turn off the whole battery if one cell hits 2.55 volts and turn it back on at 2.8 volts. This is my understanding how this works. There is a release delay of 20 seconds. I think this is to prevent the BMS from turning on, off, on, off, on, off, if these two numbers are set too close to each other, which they are not. So if we hit 2.55, it will take a while to recharge actually the battery then until it hits 2.8 again. So there are a couple of ampere hours going into the battery. It's not like this is done immediately, right? And solar charge controllers are turned off. So there's nothing coming in. So once it hits 2.55, I would expect it will turn off and will never turn back on because there's no charge coming in. Just a test. Okay, we are at 2.7. And I'll just turn on the irrigation pump here. It should kick in a second, there it is. And now we should see cell number 6 dropping relatively fast until we hit 2.5, right? I'll leave the load on. Okay, we are still discharging the battery with 16 amps. And battery number 6 is at 2.65, so 0.1 volt less, and we will be there. Then the BMS should turn off. So at the moment everything is turned on, power is running. Let's wait. 2.58, dropping. So we should be there any second. Pump is still running, 16 amps, pulling. So at 2.55 it should beep, and then shortly after it should turn off. 2.55, we are under 2.55. Is this the 20 second delay now? Maybe that's too long then. There it is. Bang, turned off. And stays off. Inverter has shut down, everything is off. All right, let's turn on charging again. Enable charger east roof. So, all right, everything. And now you can hear that. See, the relay clicked twice, the inverter is still off. And now the inverter is turning back on.
And we have not reached the 2.8 volts I have set. It's discharging the battery again because it has detected there's charge coming in. And look what happens now. I don't know why this is happening. This should not happen. This is turning on the load, off the load, on, off, on, off. And we are under 2.55 volts. Why is it doing that? This is only happening when charge is coming in. When the charger is off, it works perfectly fine. But it seems like it is detecting the charge now coming in and it wants to turn on the load again. And then after a while it stops. So you can see there is power coming in from the solar. It's recharging the battery now, but the inverter is still off. There's no light, nothing. The relay is, the light comes back on, load turns on above 2.55 volts. Now we're going under again, and the same game happens again. And I think this is not correct. Something is not right, but I cannot figure out what it is. It, there again, turns off. You can hear the relay, on, off, on, off. Now charge is coming in, and watch the voltage there, 2.553. Cell number 6. I think this is the 20-second delay now. Light comes on and the game starts again. Okay, let me turn off this pump. Yeah, does it again. We are under 2.55. And it says protection cell under voltage, which is correct because we are under 2.55. Now we are just above 2.55 and then the protection turns off and now it's charging again. But why is it not waiting until 2.8 volts, what we have set? You will see the light coming on in any moment when the inverter turns back on. Charging with 7 amps from solar. It should not turn on the inverter before 2.8 volts. So if you would have an active balancer now, what would the balancer do? It would try to discharge the higher voltage cells and put the energy into the cells with a lower voltage, right? So it would try to charge number 6, 7 and 8 now from number 4 and other cells which are higher in voltage. So it would completely destroy your top balancing and would try to bottom balance the battery now. It will always try to balance, bottom balance, medium balance, a bit more medium balance, middle balance, a bit higher balance and top balance again. It would always try to balance. So, and now, because the pump is turned off, it'll work. We still got no power here. The inverter is still turned off, but why is it doing it this time and not the three times before? I've tested this morning twice and I said, well, it's not working. So I got the camera out and did the test again, and you just saw it, what it does with the relay on, off, on, off. And now the third time, it seems to work, right? 2.66 rising, and just wait until we hit 2.8 in cell number 6, and then the inverter should come on. 2.798, 2.799. 2.8. Nothing happens.
That's the 20 second delay now. That is 20 seconds at least. Nothing. Doesn't turn on anymore. I don't know. Under voltage 2.55. Under voltage release 2.8. The delay is 20 seconds. These are the three parameters which should now kick in. But it doesn't. It doesn't turn on our load anymore. What is going on with this BMS? Warnings. Okay, let me turn off the inverter, which is off anyway, and then we turn it back on. There we go.
See, what I think is happening here.
This is coming from the battery here. And if the switch is off in between, there's no power on this side here going to our load and charge controllers. But this black wire here sits on the output of the relay. So we could see we already could charge the battery, but the load was turned off.
As soon as I turned off the inverter and turned it back on, it demanded power from the BMS, from the battery. The BMS detected it and connected the relay. So obviously with this little black wire there, there's already some power going in and out of the battery, and the BMS senses what is going on. And this is such a weird constellation, I think. And you have just seen what happens when we hit the low voltage disconnect. The relay is going on, off, on, off, on, off. And I have no idea why it does this sometimes and sometimes not. So guys, I know a lot of you guys have got the QUCC BMSs as well, and the JB, JKB, JJB, JDK, the very similar BMS as well. So let me know in the comments down below what you think, why this is happening, what kind of parameters I have set wrong. Yeah guys, so far this update from today with the QUCC relay BMS and the weird behavior when the voltage is really low. I think the problem is almost by design, because the relay can only turn on and turn off both charging and discharging. So if one of the cells is under the threshold, the relay will turn off. It will turn off the load, but it also turns off the charge, right? And this is why the black cable is on the output of the relay. So the BMS can actually sense what is happening on the outside world. If it detects charge is coming in, it turns on the relay again because it wants to charge, right? It wants to charge. It makes sense. But then the voltage of this one cell is still under the threshold. It says, oh, there's something wrong. I turn off the discharging. And it turns off again. And it does this about 20, 30 times until the voltage is over this threshold again. And then it leaves the relay on to charge. But this is just shitty behavior, right? This is just not how it's supposed to work. It should not turn on the relay again until we reach the low voltage recovery voltage again. But it turns on the relay exactly at 2.55 volts again, which is our low voltage disconnect. But this should not be the same as the recovery voltage. We've got two parameters to be set in the configuration for that. But it doesn't follow these rules. So I'm not sure, guys. I don't like this. So I'll do some more testing with the JK BMS with the MOSFETs. They seem to work perfectly. But let's see. I'll do the first charging test right now. And let's see how the JK BMS performs in this situation then. Okay, guys. Thank you so much for all your support here on the channel. Thanks for all your donations, for your financial support, which keeps these videos coming here. And until the next video, guys, stay charged, stay safe, and thank you so much for watching again. See you then. Bye-bye.